In the previous section, we have extensively covered the Pandas library in Python. In this section, we are going to study about conditional statements, the if statement, and loops, the for loop. Let us begin with conditional statements. What if there were no decisions to be made in life? This is purely a rhetorical question, since there are always decisions to be made, both in real life and, of course, in programming. Conditional statements helps us to make decisions in programming based on conditions. So far we have accomplished predefined tasks, but what makes programming more interesting is the ability to test a variable against a value, and to make the program act in a particular way. We can check if a particular condition is met by the variable or not, and then program responses separately for these two cases. These statements are known as if conditional statements. Consider this simple statement: if it rains today, I will take an umbrella. Here, umbrella is your variable which you would be taking along, if and only if, it rains. In Python, the syntax for an if statement is as follows. Let us see this example. Here, if the condition 1 is true, the statements in the statement underscore block underscore 1 will be executed. If not, then condition underscore 2 would be checked. If condition underscore 2 is evaluated to be true, then the statements in statement underscore block underscore 2 would be executed. If condition underscore 2 is also false, then the condition underscore 3 would be checked. If condition underscore 3 is evaluated to be true, then the statements in statement underscore block underscore 3 will be executed. In the programming languages, there are many situations when you need to execute a block of code several numbers of times. A loop statement allows us to execute a statement or group of statements multiple times. The following diagram illustrates a loop statement. Let us have a look at a for loop. The general syntax for a for loop is as follows. Here, the block of statements within the loop will get executed until all sequence elements get exhausted. Once all sequence elements are exhausted, the program will come out of the loop. For further clarity, consider this simple example of closing prices of stock ABC. Here, we have created this loop, where the closing prices are stored in a list, close underscore price underscore ABC. This list is our sequence. Now, let us create a for loop. Here, I is the variable, which helps you to temporarily store each element of the sequence during a single round of the iteration process. The variable I first stores the value 300 in it, and runs it through the loop to execute the statements. Here, we have placed a condition that, if I equals to 300, we will print no new positions. Hence, as you can see, this is the first statement in our output. Now, I will run through the sequence and pick the second element of the sequence, which is 305. It will run it through the statements of the loop. When I equals 305, it will execute the block, where, if I greater than 300, print, we sell. Check the second output. Similarly, it will keep executing all the elements of the loop. You may pause the video to check the outputs of all the elements of our sequence. Finally, it will come out of the loop and execute the other part of the program, that is print, we are now out of the loop. The above lecture is just an introduction to conditional statements and loops. For more, stay tuned for the IPython notebooks. Keep learning.